If you bum a cigarette off of someone, you're supposed to smoke it with them. Don't take it and walk away. That's rude. If someone gives you a cigarette, smoke it with them and then go your separate ways. You might have a nice conversation. You never know.
I'm a smoker. I like cigarettes themselves, the act of smoking. I like the culture of smoking.
So many people smoke. So many. If you walk down the street, everyone's smoking. It's a smoker circle. It's more of a community. Yeah. It's a social thing.
I've met a lot of my friends during cigarette breaks. After class cigarette is probably like the most crucial point of the day.
But obviously there are things I don't like about cigarettes. I don't like that if I smoke them my whole life, they're probably gonna kill me. I don't like that they make me smell so bad. And I don't like getting these looks like I'm shitting on your carpet when I light up outside.
But now we have e-cigarettes. They probably won't kill me. They smell great, and I can smoke them just about anywhere. Because when you use an e-cigarette, you're not actually smoking.
Calling it an e-cigarette is really a misnomer because it's not a cigarette. It doesn't involve tobacco at all. There's no tobacco in the product.
That's Mike Siegel at the School of Public Health. He spent the past 25 years trying to get people to quit smoking. He also happens to be one of the country's most outspoken advocates for e-cigarettes.
I think that there's been a misconception among many people in public health that smoking addiction is just nicotine addiction. And that's just not true. Any smoker can tell you that there's a lot of other aspects of the behavior that are part of the addiction, the holding of the cigarette, the physical sensation. 80% of smokers that you interview actually want to quit smoking. And so the reason why I am so supportive of the idea of electronic cigarettes is because for the first time, we have a product that not only addresses the pharmaceutical aspect of smoking addiction, the nicotine, but also addresses the behavioral aspects and the social aspects.
That's my friend Dale. He's one of those 80% of smokers who'd like to quit.
Have you thought about e-cigarettes?
I have. I bought a few e-cigarettes last semester, and they were nice. For some reason, I think I really like the idea of smoke in my mouth, and I know I get vapor in my mouth, but e-cigarettes for me never really did it.
Emily, on the other hand, has almost completely switched from tobacco cigarettes to an electronic alternative. She uses a vapor pen.
Have you been happy with the pen?
Definitely, very happy with the pen. The only thing that bothers me about these is like, when it breaks, I'm hopelessly addicted to nicotine. Like, you don't get all the negative side effects of a cigarette, but like, my coil floods, I have to smoke bogeys, you know? It's not helping me quit.
What would you say to someone like that, where they're not necessarily using an e-cigarette as a means to end smoking or to switch smoking, but just as another device to supplement their nicotine addiction?
So there are studies out there which show that if you look at the natural history of dual users, many dual users actually become ex-smokers. So it's a good thing. Yeah. We want them to use e-cigarettes.
Even if it's all day, every day, going hard?
Absolutely. I would much rather someone use e-cigarettes all day than that they smoke once a week.
That's a pretty big endorsement, Siegel. But down at BU Medical School, Avi Spear isn't so sure. Spear's lab researches the genetic effects of smoking on the cells in your throat, and they've recently started doing the same experiments on the vapor from e-cigarettes.
We know that regular tobacco smoke has serious consequences on cells that line the airway and predisposing them to become lung cancer. We have similar concerns about electronic cigarettes, and what we've seen so far, at least in culture, outside of the body, is when you take those cells and put them in a dish and expose them to electronic cigarette smoke, you induce some negative changes in the genes. Genes that are changed with regular tobacco smoke are changed in a similar manner with electronic cigarette smoke. And that is concerning, of course, because we know traditional tobacco products lead to cancers. And this is suggesting that electronic cigarettes might have some of the same negative health consequences.
Okay, so maybe e-cigarettes will kill me too. At least they don't smell bad. And it's not like I don't know the risks. Everybody and their mother knows the risks of smoking. Since the 1964 Surgeon General's report on the negative health effects of smoking, the marketing and sales of tobacco products have been so tightly controlled that you can't help but know that these things will probably kill you. It says it right there on the pack. But what about e-cigarettes?
I'm Steven Dorff. I've been a smoker for 20 years, and I just found the smarter alternative. Blue e-cigs.
There is no regulation, to my knowledge, on the marketing or advertising of e-cigarettes right now.
That's John Carroll at the College of Communication. He's an expert on advertising in the tobacco industry.
The tobacco companies used to have a saying, I don't want to sell you your first cigarette, I want to sell you your second one. And in a way, that's the way the e-cigarette marketers are working too. They're looking to appeal to as many consumers as they can. They are doing things like introducing these wide ranges of flavors. So you've got maybe 7,000 flavors of e-cigarettes out there. And The question is that an attempt to attract a younger audience? Some people say yes, the e-cigarette manufacturers say no, and they say our tests and studies have proven that the flavor really appeals more to consumers in their 40s than it does to consumers under the age of 21 or 18.
That's gotta be bullshit. All you have to do is go to one party in Austin to see kids showing off all the different flavors of nicotine juice they've got for their e-cigarettes.
What flavor you got in here?
Andromeda plus menthol burst. I smoke a lot of flavors. These are like a few different ones. That's strawberry limeade. That's like a mix between pomegranate and blueberry.
I had like a really good banana one. And I was just like, what is, this doesn't taste like tobacco at all. I'm just like smoking banana.
A lot of people in the anti-smoking community are dead set against e-cigarettes. They think the flavors are a gateway that will get non-smokers hooked on nicotine.
This is a really important point. And the biggest danger is, what if electronic cigarettes cause people, especially young people, who would not have smoked, to become addicted to nicotine and go on and transition to smoking?
Do you have any friends that kind of just picked up the e-cigarette without having smoked cigarettes previously?
I have a few friends that like don't smoke cigarettes but will puff e-pens, but I don't have any friends that like own an e-pen that haven't smoked cigarettes at some point in their past.
I think it's still a new phenomenon, and I think there will be people that do that. But all my friends have started off smoking regular cigarettes and then turned to e-cigarettes as a way to like hone it down.
They all use it as a healthier alternative.
So if you've got to have a nicotine fix, are e-cigarettes at least better for you than burning tobacco?
I think they are safer than traditional cigarettes. I think it's intuitive that what is being burnt in an electronic cigarette cartridge is inherently different than tobacco products that release a series of known carcinogens when they're burnt. And I don't believe it's realistic that everyone's going to stop smoking. So I think overall having a product like e-cigarette available is going to be a positive, in that at least there's an alternative to a regular tobacco product for these folks, for that small percent that will never quit, and even a percent that are going to use them together but reduce the amount of regular tobacco they're exposed to.
Overall, I still feel like it's been a really good help in my life, because I would still be smoking like cigarettes all the time. And I don't know, they just make me feel like crap. There's all the stuff in them, they just headaches when you don't have them, and it's bad. So I think it definitely has helped. Even if I like break sometimes and have to smoke cigarettes again, I know that it's always back there, and my lungs have thanked me very much.
Good. Can I take a drag?
Yes.
So, if you're a smoker and trying to cut back, an e-cigarette might help. Just don't act like they're totally risk-free. But if you're not a smoker and thinking about picking an e-cigarette up, you might want to think twice.